For some reason, people keep requesting tours of the shop, and because I don't have time for a project this week, I thought I'd do another tour, this time focusing on layout. And to give you a better sense, I'll only move the camera while it's actually filming.
So this corner of the shop is where I actually do most of my work, where I've got the drill press, the bandsaw, and the table saw, and my workbench, which are the most frequently used things in my shop. And then towards the back here, I've got my belt sanders, thickness planer, panda rotor, slot mortiser, jointer, right now this dust collector, my 18-inch bandsaw, my other panda rotor, which is parked right now, and my old table saw, which mostly I just used a rotor lift on it. And back here, I've got my miter saw, which I use almost never. And then here, I've got some firewood for material. Up here is my air cleaners, some clamps here, and then looking back here, the big dust collector back here.
So the stuff I've got back here, I've never actually changed the layout of this part here, because I wanted my main area to be where I've got these two windows. Right now this one's got the diffuser on it. And so this is a rather tight space. I figured a workbench right here made the most amount of sense because there's no window here. And so I put all my tools there. The table saw, I didn't want it against the wall, but I want it nearby. So right here is the only place that that could go. And then I've pretty much always had a bandsaw right here because it's very convenient to just turn to it and make a little cut. And then the workbench is against the windows. And that layout has worked for me really well. It's really convenient most of the time.
But it's not perfect. The way this table saw is right here, it's impossible to break up a full sheet of plywood. And the reason for that is there's this column right here which holds up the rest of the house, and that I cannot move. I took advantage of it by putting some electrical sockets on it. Even a half sheet of 5x5 plywood, if I try to cut across that, I end up hitting this column. So very annoying, but fortunately I almost never buy full sheets of plywood. I have at times used my old table saw to rip something that I couldn't do here because I'd hit this column. The other thing that is inconvenient here is with these workbenches up against the wall, I can't film from the other side and I can't work on both sides of a large workpiece. A lot of times if I work on a piece of furniture, I'll put it right here and then I kind of have to walk around it and that gets awkward. So a little bit more room in here would have been more convenient, but as it is, having the drill press, table saw, bandsaw, workbench so close together certainly has its advantages as well. Another machine that would be advantageous to have close by would be these two belt sanders. I come back here quite often and a lot of times I'll have my thickness planer or my jointer in the way, so I kind of have to snake around them. So if I had more room here, maybe I would have the sanders closer by. But at the same time, having them further from where I do the work is nice because that means the dust stays here. I don't like using a router on my workbench, for example, because then I got chips all over the place. And speaking of dust, I used to have the table saw hooked up to my big dust collector, but I switched it to having just this little dust collector that sucks the air out of it. I'm not entirely convinced this is working optimally. I've got some blow-by with the filters, and the blower is not as powerful as it could be. But these two mini dust collectors hooked up to my sanders, I'm quite happy with how those work. And right now the planer and the jointer have just got pieces of dryer hose on them, because whenever I've been using them recently, I've been hooking them up to this dust collector, which was kind of an experiment, and it works just fine with the planer and the jointer, so it's quite successful that way. This one could use a bigger fan, and in fact I've already got a bigger fan that I built out of a dishwash motor. It's basically the same design as the one on here, but not quite as big, because that other motor is just a little bit weaker than this one. And that would be good on here, except there's no room, so I have to figure out what to do there. but I'm not going to tweak that while it's in this shop. Now back here, everything back here is on wheels except for the stuff against this wall. And I've rolled everything out of the way and used this as a party room a few times. If I work on something very large, I tend to push the machines up against the wall so I have a large empty area. Like when I made a queen size bed, I assembled it right where the jointer is right now. Right now it's not too crowded, but at times, like when I build a new machine, I had my 20 inch bandsaw in here and another tool stand and this and that. It's gotten crowded back here at times, but then I just move stuff out of the way again. The tool stand that I built most recently is in my big garage workshop out in the country. So once again, this pantry rotor is just parked on a stool. Let's see, what else have we got in here? This shelf is more chaos, and it's got a bunch of old projects on here. You may or may not remember when I did this. This is my screw jack for joint strength testing, which I'll probably use again in the future. This little box with the purple glue, I'm sure some of you will guess where that came from. My impossible looking dovetail joints, the wooden ball bearing, the cube within a cube within a cube, the violin scrolls, several of them, the fancy Japanese joint thingy. So all kinds of little novelty things that have no particular use. This was from doing a gear wear test, ran it for over 24 hours straight, no sign of wear on it. What else have we got here? Oh yeah, the multi-lap joint from when I was demonstrating my Quickset tenon jig. An irregular box joint. This goes way, way back to before I was making videos. The right angle pseudo bevel gears. That video wasn't very popular. And this is one of the gears from when I was doing the 1 to 12 clock gear thing. And a recessed drawer knob, which I carved out with my pantograph. That was pretty novel, but the video wasn't very popular. I'm trying to think of anything else that might be interesting or new. But so much of this I've covered, so I'll put links to my old shop tours in the video description. Oh yeah, here's my lathe stand, which I now have really not used in a very long time because since I built the homemade lathe, I've used that. This one is much more rigid and larger capacity, but it's inconvenient to use and I like trying out my homemade tools just to see if I run into problems. So I've really not had an incentive to use this lathe even when I was doing turning. And one more thing that I try to show as little as possible in the videos is the ceiling, because it's quite low, because this house was built in 1954. So this has been a very cozy shop, very convenient having it in the basement because it's always at a reasonable temperature, even if it's hot or cold outside. And I will miss this aspect of the shop, and this is what brings me to the video title. This is the last tour of this shop because we are moving out to the country. So while I might still do a few more projects in here, I will definitely not do another shop tour in here. In the next few months, everything in here is going to get moved out to my big garage workshop out in the country, which is much bigger, but much less cozy. Even though my big garage workshop is at least twice the size of my basement workshop, the layout in here has not been working for me. I think part of the problem is that I've got the ATV in here and the tractor. And back here it's dedicated to the wood stove, and then I've got my metalworking area in here, and I still need to be able to get the tractor out. So I haven't actually had that much room for the woodworking stuff. So that's something that's going to get improved over the next few months. I think I have a better place to park the tractor now, so the first thing to do is to get that out of the shop. And for that, I have to clear some stuff out of the way. Oops, hit the ATV there. Let's see how this works, if this works.
I think the tractor's too long.
Yeah, it'll poke out at the end a little bit.
Mm.
Ta-da!
Actually, it fits.
Snug as a bug.
Yeah.
Wow.
Darn, I really wanted a smaller tractor.
I measured that it would fit, but just, it didn't seem like it would.